for our next candidate, we have for the Valdosta School Board, District 4, Tyra Howard. So Tyra, please join us. And again, we'll have opening comments in terms of, introducing yourself and your issues. Thank you.
Good afternoon. First, I want to thank AAUW for the invitation out tonight. I am Tyra Howard, the proud wife of Eric Howard, and I'm the mother of Matrice, a Boston State graduate, Aaron Howard, a fifth grader, and a four-year-old that's in preschool at Bright Star. I am a graduate from Ball State University. I have a bachelor in science and education, and I have my master's from Walden University. I'm a strong believer of transparency and integrity. I will serve the school board with those, I will serve the school board with those principles. Again, I would like to thank everyone for the invite out tonight, and I look forward to serving on the school board. And if you have any questions after the event tonight, I'll get around. Thank you.
If we can keep it. So from our audience members, our first question is, what plans do you have to improve the lives of high school dropouts in our area and help them to be productive members in society? So what plans do you have to improve the lives of high school dropouts in our area and to help them be productive members in society?
Well, first of all, I would have to see what plans are already in place. And the plans are already in place. I see where there is communication barriers because I'm sure the counselors or even the teachers are aware of those students that are on the at the verge of dropping out. And if there's something we can implement to stop that or do differently, I'm all for it. I'll do whatever I can do on my end as a board member to help and assist to stop the drop, to decrease the dropout rate.
We also have a second question from our audience is, what can you do in local government to make our children's education of a higher quality and to divert funds to the public school students who most need support? So what can you do in local government to make our children's education of a higher quality and to divert funds to the public school students who most need support?
Well, I'm sure there's policies and procedures, so there's not one thing that I can personally do to make those things change. What I can do is, if I see where there's some issues that one school is getting more funding than another school, is to find out why. Because I'm sure there are different economic status of kids in every school. So one school may need more funding versus another school. It just really just depends on the school.
And if you'd like to wrap up
for the end of it?
Thank you.